Hello friends, our fifth application of Schrodinger's steady state equation is a potential barrier. Okay, so a diagrammatical representation of potential barrier is like this. I have drawn already. This is the particle is moving along the x direction, opposite x direction, at x equal to x zero. There is a potential barrier, which is a potential barrier of V0, and it finishes at x equal to A. After x equal to A, again the potential is 0, and therefore there are three regions. One, the region 1 is with a V equal to 0. Region 2 with a V is equal to V naught, and region 3 a V is equal to again a V zero. Okay, so there are three regions, means we have to write the three simultaneous equations for a steady state equation. So general expression we already known, so that is the a d2 sine by a dx square plus a 2m by h bar square e minus v sum is equal to 0. So this is the Schrodinger's steady state equation. So for the first region, a v equal to 0, and therefore for first region it is written as a d2 psi by a d psi 1 plus 2m E by H cross psi 1 is equal to 0. So this is equation 1. Okay, the same equation for the second region with V equal to V naught, and therefore this can be written as a d2 psi 2 by a dx square plus 2m by H bar square E minus a V naught psi 2 is equal to 0. So this is the second region, second equation, and in third region again V equal to 0, and therefore so this is the d2 psi 3 by dx square plus 2m e by h bar square psi 3 is equal to 0. Here also this V equal to 0, and therefore somewhat this equation is the same. Only thing, this is in region 3, therefore we consider as the wave function psi 3. So psi 1, psi 2 and psi 3, so according to, so this is equation 3. Okay, as usual, so this is equal to a k, and therefore this d2 psi 1 by dx square plus a k square psi 1 is equal to 0, equation 2 for this one. And here is a same case, then we afterward will see. And this is also the a k square, and therefore a d2 psi 3 by dx square plus 2m, instead of that the k square psi 3 is equal to 0. So this is the equation. Next one, say 3, 4. Here. Now, here there are the two cases. If the E minus V naught, if E is greater than V naught, then there is one case. So, where this E is greater than V naught, and if E is less than V naught, then second case, and therefore so there are the two cases here. So one is for this, and therefore this we may put as alpha square, and we write this equation a d2 psi 2 by a dx square plus alpha square psi 2 is equal to 0, say equation 3. Okay, So general expression for this is a sine of x is equal to a e raised to I k x plus b e raised to minus I k x, where so this is the incident wave. Incident wave. So this is for reflected wave. Reflected wave. Okay, this we'll see afterward. And expression for that psi 3 is equal to all psi 2 is equal to psi 2 psi 3 of x psi 3 of x is equal to c e raised to I kx plus d e raised to minus I kx. Here e raised to minus I, so this is the transmitter. So this is the transmitted wave. This is a transmitted wave and this is the reflected. But when we are the crossing this barrier and entering into the third region, so there is no a probability of reflection back. Okay, so probability of the reflection back from this only. After crossing the barrier, when we are entering into the third region, so there is no probability of the coming back. And therefore, this D is equal to 0, the reflection coefficient in the third region is 0, and hence, this psi 3 of x is equal to c e raised to I k x. So, this is the expression, say phi. Okay, so this psi 3 of x is equal to c e raised to I k x. Now, the solution of this second region is equal to this is the f e raised to I alpha x plus g e raised to minus I alpha x. Okay, so this e raised to I k alpha x is a passing transmitted one. And this is the coefficient which is the reflected. So this represents the reflected coefficient. This represents a transmission coefficient from this region. So there is another exercise is nothing but to find out this value A, B, C, F and G. So this is the major exercise. To find out this constant values using the boundary conditions. Okay, after that when we calculating this boundary condition, after that we calculate as we seen in last article, we are very familiar for the that is the current density. Using that current density, we will calculate the current density for G incident, then G reflected and J transmitted. Okay, and from that we find out the T is equal to J in J transmitted divided by J incident, and R reflected is equal to J reflected divided by J incident. From these values, and for these values, so this ratio is coming into the in terms of A, B, F, G, and C. Okay, and therefore the next exercise is to find out values for this constant, that is to determine values of a constant using the boundary condition. So which boundary conditions we are using here? This one. And so this is the one boundary at x equal to 0. At x equal to 0, this psi 1 x equal to 0. And another one is at x equal to a. At x equal to a, this is psi 2 is 0 and psi 3 is equal to 0. And second boundary condition, it's the first derivative of the psi 2 and third derivative of the psi 3 is also 0. So here also the second boundary condition first derivative of psi 1 at x equal to 0 is equal to a first derivative of psi 2 at x equal to 0. Okay, using that boundary condition, we are going to find out the constant values in terms of a, b, f, g, and c. So this is psi 1 of x is equal to 0. Simultaneously, this boundary here, this psi 2 of x is equal to 0. Okay, and therefore, the value of psi 1 is equal to a mod of psi 2. So this is the first boundary, and second boundary, its first derivative, the value of psi 1 by psi at x equal to 0 is equal to a psi 2 by d psi 2 by at x equal to 0. So this equation will solve and will give the values between this a, f and g, and from that we calculate. So in second boundary condition at x equal to a, what happens at x equal to a, this side is a psi 2 and this side is the psi 3. At x equal to a, this value of the psi 2 is equal to value of the psi 3 and mod value of the psi 3. So this is the first and second one is its first derivative psi 2 of x at x equal to a is equal to a psi 3 of d psi 3 by dx at x equal to a. So its derivative with respect to x at x equal to a is equal to the value of the derivative at x equal psi 3 of x d psi 3 by dx at x equal to a. By considering these values, and we find out this psi 3 psi 2 of x psi 2 of x is equal to f e raised to I alpha x plus g e raised to minus I alpha x. So this is about the psi 2, and psi 1 we already known. So a e raised to I kx plus b e raised to minus I kx, and psi 3 we are already known. Psi 3 is equal to c e raised to I a kx. B is a 0 because there is no reflection. Putting this value, psi 1 at mod of psi 1 is equal to mod of psi 2, and first differentiation with respect to x at x equal to 0 is equal to differentiation of this. By solving these, we get this constant. And what are these constants? These constants are, and value of the b is equal to this k minus alpha divided by 2k f plus k plus alpha divided by 2k into g. So this is a coefficient, this is a constant b. Now f is equal to k plus alpha divided by 2 alpha c e raised to I k a into e raised to minus I alpha a into e raised to minus I alpha a. So this is value of f, and the constant value of g is alpha minus k divided by 2 alpha c e raised to I k a into e raised to I alpha a. Okay, now using these constants, we are going to find out a transmission coefficient and a reflection coefficient. Okay, and therefore we know that the transmission coefficient T is equal to J trans divided by J incident, and this gives mod of C by A, this one. Okay, it's equal to, so this mod of C is nothing but C into C star divided by A into A star, and by solving this we get a transmission coefficient as 1 plus this V naught square is sine square alpha a divided by 4 e e minus a b 0. Okay, so this is your a transmission. And reflection coefficient r is equal to, we know that the reflection coefficient r is equal to this j reflection divided by j incident is equal to in terms of b by a. So this is the b by a mod square is equal to b b star divided by a a star, and its value is 1 upon 4 e e minus v 0 divided by a v naught square is sin square alpha a plus 1. So this is value for the reflection. If you see the formulas coming out for the t and r is easily you can see t plus r is equal to 1. So that can we solve it. So this r plus t is equal to, first this is the 4 e e minus v naught divided by a v naught square in this sin square alpha a plus 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus a v naught square a sin square alpha a divided by 4 e e minus a v naught. You see the these formulas, then this is in below, where this is the in upside, and therefore by solving this we can easily come into the equation 1. Okay, so that the r plus t is equal to 1. So this is the general expression for Schrodinger's equation for second region, and d2 psi by dx square plus 2m by h bar square e minus v psi 2 is equal to 0. And there are the two cases we have seen. One is e greater than v naught, and e is the less than v naught. In case of the e is greater than v naught, we have seen a t plus r is equal to 1. So a t transmission coefficient plus reflection coefficient is equal to e is 1. So that we have seen. So what is the value of t? The value of t is t is equal to 1 upon 1 plus v naught sin square alpha a divided by 4 e minus a v naught. Okay, now this equation shows that the transmission coefficient is less than 1. Is less than 1 means there is no 100% a transmission. So there is a partial reflection at x equal to 0 and at x equal to a. So this is the wave coming from the first region, incident on the boundary. At the boundary, according to this equation, so there is a partial reflection and partial transmission. So this is happening at x equal to 0. The same thing also at x equal to a. So at x equal to a, so there is a partial reflection and a partial transmission is expressed. And therefore, this t is less than equal to 1. So that is not in case of the classical. In classical, we have seen the when e is greater than v0, greater than v0, your the t capital T is the transmission coefficient is equal to 1, means all the particles are able to cross over the boundary. Okay, now at what values this is sin square alpha and this term is equal to 0. If this is 0, then t is equal to 1, means total transmission. So this is the condition. Mathematically, what is that condition? Is sin square alpha a should be 0, then this equation becomes 0, and therefore t is equal to 1, total transmission. And then alpha A is equal to n point, and n is equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. Means for this angle, this sine term is equal to 0 and T is equal to 1. Means there is no barrier, all the particles are easily cross over the barrier as if there is no barrier at all. And this is the interesting phenomenon in a quantum mechanical physics. Okay, so if you draw at T is equal to 1 here, so this is the at T is equal to 1, and here it is the alpha A. Okay, then so this is happening at pi, this maximum is at 2 pi, this is maximum at 3 pi, and so on. Okay, and this is at pi by 2, this is at 2 pi by 2. Means the same thing, this is this transmission like interference phenomenon what observing in light. Okay, so this is your first case. In second case, what is the condition? The condition is that E is less than V0. E is less than V0. And therefore, this equation, we are putting alpha square is equal to 2m by alpha square E minus V0. Alpha square is equal to minus, you transfer this V0 because E is less than V naught, and therefore put alpha square is equal to I beta. Whatever the equation in T and R, we have T is equal to, just now here it was, so this is the 1 plus V naught square is sine square alpha A divided by 4 E minus V naught. Put in this value alpha square, so this alpha square is nothing but the I, so this alpha is equal to this I beta, and therefore sine square beta, that term becomes as a T is equal to 1 upon 1 plus V naught square, this I square is sine square. So this is the I beta, sin square I beta. Okay, and there is another formula. So this is sin square I theta is equal to I sin square theta, I square sin square theta. And therefore, this term becomes finally right, sin hyperbolic square beta A into this I square divided by 4E as it is. So this is the E minus V naught, and R is equal to the opposite of that one, is equal to 4E divided by E minus V naught divided by V naught square into a sine hyperbolic square beta A plus 1. So this is the R. Okay, so this equation shows that there is some small probability of the finding the particle across the border. So this is again, it is less than 1. Less than 1 means there is a probability of the finding the particle in third region. That means it is a cross over the border. And therefore, in classical, what happens when E is less than V0? So there is no particle is crossing the border, crossing this barrier. But in quantum mechanical phenomena, even E is less than V0, so there is a small probability of the finding the particle in third region, and that is called a tunneling effect, barrier tunneling. So this is a very important phenomenon in quantum mechanically we have proved. So the, and there are the many more applications of the tunneling effect in electronics devices. So this is the second case, and here we completed a fifth application. So that is the barrier penetration using the quantum mechanical and classically. So classically there is a forbidden region. Classically the particle will not cross over the border. What happened classically? So this is over the border, and classically particle with E, it will not cross over the border, so forbidden. But in case of the quantum mechanically, it will cross over the border with some decrease in kinetic energy, with the same and passing into the third region. So this is the second region in which, and this is the psi is equal to say some constant A e raised to I minus I alpha x. So because of this exponential term, so this is the tuning, so exponential decay is there, and the same here is the crossing, and this is called the tunneling. Tunneling phenomenon is used in the many more devices in electronics.